Hi guys, in this video we will learn about types of utility function for indifference curve. So let's start. So what is utility function? A utility function is usually represented by this form, where x1, x2, x3 and so on are the number of goods a consumer purchased to satisfy his or her wants. So in this video we will use two good utility function to understand what is utility function and the type of utility function. So first we have to note that there are no unique utility function representation for all preference relations in economics, but there are four commonly used utility function in economics that we will discuss one by one here in this video. So first is your Cobb-Douglas utility function, which is represented by this general form, where a and b are constant number greater than 0. The example of Cobb-Douglas production function can be, for example, utility where x is 0.5 and y is 0.5 and also x is 1 and y is 1. Okay, so the function will be like this for a Cobb-Douglas utility function. To plot a Cobb-Douglas utility function on the graph, we have to first understand what is modulative substitution in the case of Cobb-Douglas utility function. To find Cobb-Douglas utility function modulative substitution, we have to use this formula, where we have to differentiate utility function with respect to x to find marginal utility of x, and we have to differentiate again marginal utility function with respect to y to find marginal utility of y. Let's differentiate utility function with respect to x first. So if you differentiate it with respect to x, you will get this. And if you differentiate with respect to y, you will get this. And if you put it in this formula, let's just put it here. It will be this and this. So if you solve it, at the end you will find this. This can be used as a shortcut. This can be used as a shortcut to find marginal utility substitution whenever you have been given a Cobb-Douglas utility function in the form of like this, or maybe this. Okay. So if you plot a Cobb-Douglas utility function graph, it will look like this. Go to x, go to y. So it will be a IC curve, rectangular hyperbola. IC1. IC2, IC3. So as you can see, the IC curve in this case is the rectangular hyperbola, is strictly convex toward origin, and here marginal rate of substitution is diminishing. Okay. Next we have a perfect substitute utility function. A perfect substitute utility function is usually represented by this form. For example, it can be in the form of like x plus 2y or 2x plus y and so on. So a perfect substitute utility function marginal rate of substitution is this. So if you use the same formula as we used in Cobb-Douglas utility function, you will find marginal rate of substitution, and in this case in this form. Okay, and this can be used as a shortcut to find marginal rate of substitution whenever you have been given a Cobb-Douglas a perfect substitute utility function like this or this. Okay, so if you plot a perfect substitute utility function graph here, it will look like this. So as you can see, it is perfectly sloped downward line from left to right. Okay, next we have a perfect complement utility function. A perfect complement utility function is usually represented by the either in the form of minimum or in the maximum. For example, you will get a perfect complement utility function will be like this and many more. Okay, one thing need to note here: in the perfect complement utility function, marginal rate of substitution cannot be calculated with the help of utility function because in this case utility function cannot be differentiated. So if you want to find a marginal rate of substitution in perfect complement case, you have to see with the help of diagram. So here is your perfect complement diagram, which is L-shaped because in perfect complement utility function, a consumer purchased two goods at the same time or in pair. Okay, at this point, at king point, we have major iota substitution undefined, and at this point, ax is equal to by. Okay, and last we have a quasi-linear utility function. A quasi-linear utility function is usually represented by this form, where one of the variable is constant and another one is non-linear. For in this case, a consumer is only interested in consumption of y and does not care about the quantity of x. Okay, so you will get a function like this, where you have 2y and x and y, okay, and so on. Okay, so in this case, in quasi-linear utility function, you always have to differentiate utility function to find marginal rate of substitution. In this case, marginal rate of substitution will be this, but there is no shortcut in the case of quasi-linear utility function to find marginal rate of substitution. So if you draw a quasi-linear utility function graph, it will look like this. Here x, a consumer does not care about the quantity of x, he only care about the quantity of y, as you can see. In this case, indifference curve is strictly convex and marginal rate of substitution is diminishing. So I will be putting more videos like this, so please like and subscribe to my channel. See you soon.